Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Hopkinton High School as the 9-7 Hopkinton Hillers take on the 14-4 Medway Mustangs. A lot on the line here for today's game. If Medway wins today, they are the TVL champions. If the Hopkinton Hillers win, they clinch a bid into the state tournament. A great pitching matchup on hand for you this afternoon. Tom Onsi on the mound for the Hopkinton Hillers. Nick Assad for the Medway Mustangs as the first hitter of the day will step in. Jeff Wenzel, the center fielder for the Medway Mustangs, set to face Tom Onsi. It is a gorgeous afternoon for baseball, temperatures in the mid-70s. Bob Hamilton on camera, Tom Nappy on the call. We are set for baseball from Hopkinton High School as the first pitch just inside 1-0 to Jeff Wenzel. Onsi set to deliver the second pitch of the game. The leg lift and the pitch. Upstairs, 2-0. Let's take a look at the Medway batting order. Jeff Wenzel, the center fielder, leading off. Nick Assad, the pitcher, will bat second. Joe Downing, the left fielder, will bat third. Tyler Monahan, the catcher, will hit in the cleanup spot as there's strike one. Jeff Costello, the third baseman, will bat fifth. Sean Patingi, the right fielder, will bat sixth. Brian Colcassi, the first baseman, will bat seventh. TJ Nelson will bat eighth. As that one's down low, TJ Nelson is the shortstop. And batting ninth, rounding out the order, is the second baseman, Jake Broder, for the Medway Mustangs, who have been very dominant this season. As there's ball four to Wenzel, leadoff hitter is on for the Medway Mustangs. Nick Assad, the pitcher, will come up to the plate. Let's take a look at the Hopkinton Hillers field. Tom Onsi on the mound, Alex Reynolds behind home plate, Ryan Wolf at first base, Kyle Halloran at second, Jack Vicari at shortstop, Jake LeBlanc, the third baseman, from left to right, Sam Lehman, Jeff Haller, and Connor Hebert for the Hopkinton Hillers. That pitch down low gets by Reynolds, and the runner, Jeff Wenzel, advances to second. And that pitch was in the zone, so I'm going to call it a pass ball on Reynolds' part. It's a runner in scoring position early on for the Medway Mustangs, as Nick Assad will step back in the batter's box. Onsi from the stretch. Nick Assad, the sophomore, a .354 batting average on the season. As this is on the ground, takes a couple hops over to second base, throw to first in time. But Wenzel advances to third. So, a nice sacrifice for Assad. One away, runner on third, Joe Downing coming to the plate. Joe Downing, a senior, at a .317 batting average on this season, has played in all 18 games for the Mustangs. As that one's fouled away, 0-1. Downing has also scored 13 runs and driven in 10. Tom Onsi gets the sign he likes and is set to deal. Runner taking a slight lead off of third. That pitch upstairs, 1-1. Tom Onsi, a nice season on the mound. In 6 appearances, 5 starts, he's 3-1 with a save to his credit, a 2.90 ERA. The leg lift and the pitch, and this is hit in the air, foul territory and out of play towards the high school track behind us. 1-2. The last time these two teams met, it was a Drew Simme versus Seth Coppinger pitching matchup, and the Hopkinton Hillers took the game 7-4. Onsi is set to deal. And this is on the ground, first base side, glove by the first baseman. He'll tag the bag, but a run will cross for the Medway Mustangs. An RBI sacrifice for Joe Downing. It's 1-0 Medway. So two away in the inning, Tyler Monahan to the plate. All right, Tyler, start it up again. Leg lift and the pitch in there for a strike. Last time these two teams met was back on May 10th in Medway. Leg lift and the pitch. Breaking pitch up high, 1-1. Monahan at a 3.46 on the season. Is that pitch up high? He has scored 11 runs, driven in 11 as well. As the cleanup catcher awaits the pitch. On the ground, third base side, gloved by the third baseman LeBlanc. Throw to first is going to take a bounce off of Wolf. And Monahan will reach on the error. That was a hard throw by LeBlanc. I don't know who to call that error on. I'm going to assume it was on the first baseman's part. Jeff Costello will come up to the plate. The senior at a 254 on the season. 15 runs scored, 9 batted in. Medway with some early momentum here in Hopkinton. Runner leading off of first, Otsi with the leg lift and the pitch, swinging strike. Nice turnout here for senior day at the Hopkinton Hillers baseball field. Last home game of the regular season. The windup and the pitch upstairs inside. Hillers one win away from clinching a bid to the state tournament. They still have 4 opportunities, including this game, to do so. Runner leading off of first, Otsi set to deliver. And this is checked out of play and out of the reach of any of the fielders, 1-2. Otsi awaiting the sign. Wide up and the pitch. And this is hit in the air over to shallow center field. Vicari ranges back to make the catch. And that will be the third out of the inning. The Medway Mustangs do plate a run in the top of the first. As we head to the bottom of the first, it's 1-0 Medway. Bottom of the first inning, the Hopkinton Hillers coming up with Medway leading 1-0. Let's take a look at the Hillers' batting order. Kyle Halloran, the second baseman, will lead things off. Jack Vicari, the shortstop, will bat second. Alex Reynolds, the catcher, hitting third. Drew Simi, the designated hitter, in the cleanup spot. Jake LeBlanc in the fifth spot, playing third base. Sam Lehman, the left fielder, will hit sixth. Jeff Haller, the center fielder, hitting seventh. Connor Hebert hitting eighth, playing right field, and Ryan Wolf, the first baseman, hitting ninth. And they will get the opportunity to hit against Nick Assad for the Medway Mustangs. And a very good pitching rotation for Medway this season. A lot of great arms in that rotation. Also a lot of great hitters in their batting order as well. Let's take a look at the Medway field. Nick Assad on the mound. Tyler Monahan is behind home plate. Brian Kolkassi, the first baseman, at second base. Jake Broder, the shortstop, TJ Nelson. At third base, Jeff Costello. From left to right, Joe Downing, Jeff Wenzel, and Sean Patingi. For the Medway Mustangs. We'll get you the stats on Nick Assad in just a moment as Kyle Halloran set to step in. Wind up and the pitch. There's strike one. 0-1. Assad deals, it's down low, 1-1. Kyle Halloran awaits the pitch. Another one down low, 2-1. Nick Assad has pitched 23 innings this season. Is that one is just low, 3-1. Assad is 1-2 in 5 appearances, 4 starts. A 3.04 ERA for the sophomore. The leg lift and the pitch. Just upstairs, and Halloran draws the walk. Jack Vaccari, the shortstop, will come to the plate. Medway Mustangs led by head coach Mike Coppinger, the Hopkinton Hillers head coach Jay Golden. As Vaccari steps in, wind up and the pitch, up in the zone for a strike. The senior Jack Vaccari at a 4.83 mark on the season, has played in all 16 games, checking at first, runner slides back safe. Vaccari has scored 19 runs, driven in 15, also has 3 home runs to his credit. The 0-1 pitch to Vaccari. Down low. Alex Reynolds, the catcher, due up on deck. He's also had a very nice season at the plate for the Hillers. As this is hit foul. 1-2. Leadoff hitter Kyle Halloran on first after a walk. No outs in the bottom of the first. Nick Assad from the stretch to Vaccari. Wind up and the pitch. And this is crushed into right center. That'll drop down. Halloran around second, over to third. It'll be runners at the corners with no outs for the Hillers. A single for Vaccari. And that'll bring up Alex Reynolds, the catcher. Alex Reynolds is a junior, hitting a 440 on the season. 11 runs scored, 15 batted in, a home run to his credit. Assad from the stretch. Down low. 1-0. Nice breeze in the air for today's game as Assad set to deliver. Runner taking off from first, pitch down low, and there will be no throw, so a stolen base for Jack Vaccari. So now you got two runners in scoring position with no outs. Assad deals in there for a strike. A 2-1 count to Reynolds. Leg lift and the pitch. And this is lined into right field. That'll drop in, and the Hillers will tie things up, and maybe more as Vaccari being waved around. It's 2-1 Hopkinton. A 2-RBI single for Alex Reynolds. Some early offense on both sides today. And that'll bring up Drew Simme. Drew Simme is a senior. He's played in all 16 games, and he's hitting at a 300 as he takes ball one. 8 runs scored, 10 driven in. Also a team-leading 8 doubles for Simme. Wind up and the pitch upstairs. And we're going to get a discussion on the mound as Tyler Monahan, the catcher, will come out and talk to Assad. Hiller's getting the offense going on early, and they certainly stacked the top of the lineup today. You had Kyle Halloran lead things off for the Hillers. He's hitting a 424 on the season. Then you got Vaccari, Reynolds, and Simme. Just a dangerous top of the order for the Hillers. And that's fouled away past the backstop, 2-1. Assad delivers. Inside, 3-1. Runner on first, 2 for the Hillers already. No outs in the bottom of the first inning. And that one is going to be called ball 4. Simi will get a free pass over to first base. Alex Reynolds pushes up to second. Jake LeBlanc to the plate. LeBlanc, the junior, hitting a .395 on the season, has scored 5 runs and batted in 10. As now the head coach, Mike Coppinger, out to the mound with the catcher, Tyler Monahan. Mustangs trying to clinch the TVL title this afternoon. Assad from the stretch. Wind up and the pitch, up high. And we're gonna get time once again. Perhaps a miscommunication between the catcher and pitcher. As the Hillers getting things going early on. Kyle Halloran walked to start off the bottom of the first. Jack Vicari then singled and stole second. The Vicari single already pushed Halloran to third, and then Reynolds with a 2-RBI single. And that was followed up with a Drew Simi walk. And this is tattooed into left field. That'll drop down in front of the left fielder, and it'll be bases juiced for the Hillers with no outs. Reynolds up to third, Simi up to second, LeBlanc over at first. Coming to the plate, Sam Lehman, the left fielder. Sam Lehman, .308 batting average, has played in 13 games this season. Wind up and the pitch. Just up high, 1-0. Lehman has scored 6 runs and batted in 3. Leg lift and the pitch, swinging strike, 1-1. Wind up and the pitch, just inside. Very precise strike zone today. But it certainly has been consistent. Wind up and the pitch. That's fouled off the catcher. 2-2. Good thing for face masks and helmets for the catcher. The 2-2 pitch. That one inside. Leg lift and the pitch. Swinging strike. That's out number 1. I'll bring up Jeff Holler. Wind up and the pitch, in there for a strike, 0-1. Jeff Holler, the senior at a .186 mark, as that pitch down low, has played in 16 games. Has scored 13 runs. Wind up and the pitch. That's fouled away. 1-2. Has driven in 6. Pump it out, Nick. You got this. You got this, Nick. Bases loaded, one out. The 1-2 pitch to Holler. Down low, 2-2. Due up next for the Hillers, Connor Hebert, the right fielder. Leg lift and the pitch. And this is first base side. That'll get into right field. Reynolds around to score. And it is 3-1 Hillers. An RBI single for Jeff Holler. I'll bring up Connor Hebert. Drew Simi now at third. Jake LeBlanc over at second. There's strike one. And of course at first, Jeff Holler. There's strike two. Connor Hebert, the sophomore, 256 batting average on the season. And he will put this one up the middle, and that'll find a gap into center field. Another Hillers run around to score as Simi comes around. It's 4-1 Hopkinton. An RBI single for Connor Hebert. And everybody pushes up a base. Blank to third, Holler to second. And now Ryan Wolf, the first baseman, to the plate. Still one out in the inning. There's strike one. Ryan Wolf, the junior, a 125 batting average on the season, has played in 11 games. As this is hit in the air above the head of the second baseman, that'll be caught for the second out. Kyle Halloran, the leadoff hitter, will come back up to the plate. Halloran walked his first time up. Takes ball one there. Wind up and the pitch. And this is going to get into left field. Another run coming around to score as LeBlanc comes around. And it's another RBI single for the Hopkinton Hillers. 5-1 is now the score. So LeBlanc in, Holler up to third, Hebert up to second, Jack Vicari to the plate. Vicari hit a single and scored a run already in this game. Nice way to start things off for the Hillers. Leg lift and the pitch. Down low. 1-0. Now, Cassad will take some time to adjust himself, and he is set to deliver. And that's fouled away behind us over the football field. 1-1. Leg lift and the pitch. In there for strike two, 1-2. And there's strike three. We'll get Vicari on the swing. And that'll be out number three for the bottom of the first, but not before the Hopkinton Hillers plate five runs. It's 5-1 as we head to the second inning. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by WPC Pest Control. Don't tolerate your pest problem. Eliminate your pest problem. You can find them online at WPCPest.com. Top half of the second inning, a 5-1 Hopkinton Hillers lead. The Medway Mustangs coming back up to the plate. The 6, 7, and 8 hitters due up for Medway as Sean Patingi awaits the first pitch from Tom Onsi. And there's strike one. Sean Patingi, Brian Kulkassi, and TJ Nelson do up for the Mustangs, the right fielder, first baseman, and shortstop. Leg lift and the pitch, and that's fouled away. 0-2. Chauncey awaits the sign and deals. Breaking pitch up high. One and two. Gets the sign he likes. He's set to deal. Turns away the hitter, but it's on the inner corner for strike three. One away. Now Brian Kulkassy will come up to the plate, the first baseman. Kulkassy, a senior, has played in all 18 games for the Mustangs. Let's take strike one there. 321 batting average, has scored 9 runs, driven in 8. Line up and the pitch. In there for strike two. Monsi shakes off a couple signs and now he's set to deal. There's strike three. Two straight strikeouts for Otzi. And now TJ Nelson, the shortstop, to the plate. Nelson at a 314 batting average as the sophomore awaits the pitch, and this is on the ground up the middle, gloved by the shortstop. Throw to first is a little high, but pulled down nicely by Ryan Wolf for the third and final out of the top of the second. They go down 1-2-3, heading to the bottom of the second. Hopkinton 5, Medway 1. Bottom of the second inning, a 5-1 Hillers lead over the Medway Mustangs. Mustangs at the top of the TVL with a 14-4 record. Hillers 9-7 coming into this game. Due up is the 3, 4, and 5 hitters for the Hillers as Alex Reynolds, the catcher, steps in. The windup and the pitch from Assad. In there for strike one. Alex Reynolds, Drew Simi, and Jake LeBlanc due up. Leg lift and the pitch, down low in the dirt, 1-1. Good turnout for this game. A lot of Medway fans made the trip down. Also a good turnout for the Hillers here on senior night at the Hopkinton baseball field. Last home game of the regular season. And this is third base side, takes a hop on the infield grass, but right to the third baseman. Throw to first, and there's out number one. Good throw across the diamond by Costello. That'll bring up Drew Simi. Simi walked in the first inning and ended up scoring one of the 5 Hillers runs. The leg lift and the pitch. And this is hit in the air towards center field. The center fielder ranging back and will make the catch. And Wenzel, no problem tracing that one down. 2 away. Now Jake LeBlanc will come up to the plate. He singled and scored a run in the first inning. Wind up and the pitch, swinging strike. Set to deliver. And up the middle, a couple hops on the infield grass, gloved by the second baseman, throw to first, no problem. And the Hopkinton Hillers go down 1-2-3 in the bottom of the second. We'll head to the top of the third. It's Hopkinton 5, Medway 1. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Golden Pond Assisted Living, honoring resident choice, dignity, and independence. Our health and wellness focus keeps residents active. Golden Pond, state-of-the-art senior housing and healthcare services. You can find them online at goldenpondassistedliving.com. Senior day here at Hopkinton High School as we enter the top half of the third inning between the Hopkinton Hillers and the Medway Mustangs. A lot on the line in this game for both teams. The Mustangs with a chance to clinch the TVL. They're already into the postseason. They're at the top of the TVL. A win here will give them the division title. And the Hillers, a chance to clinch a bid to the state tournament as Ansi delivers to the leadoff man, or excuse me, the ninth hitter in the lineup, Jake Broder, the second baseman. First pitch inside and high, 1-0. Leg lift and the pitch. There's strike one, 1-1. 9-1-2 due up for the Mustangs. Wind up and the pitch, upstairs. Mustangs a good offensive team overall, hitting at a team total of 282 batting average. Leg lift and the pitch. There's a strike. 2-2. And you could compare that to the Hillers, who are also a very good offensive team. The Hillers hitting at a 328 as a team. As their strike three. One away. Two good offensive teams, and you have two good pitchers as well today, as Jeff Wenzel will step in. Wenzel walked and scored a run in the first. Scored on a Joe Downing RBI sacrifice. That pitch up high. 1-0. Ansi set to deliver. That one low. Two and oh. Leg lift and the pitch. In there for a strike, 2-1. The senior Jeff Wenzel, 254 batting average on the season. Takes that one inside. Has scored 15 runs, driven in four. Leg lift and the pitch. Inside, ball four. Second walk of the day for Ansi. And second walk of the day for the hitter, Jeff Wenzel, as well. Nick Assad steps in, grounded out his last time up. Trying to help his own cause here with one on, one out. There's ball one. Hit in the air towards shallow center field. And it is going to drop in for a base hit. No one could get there in time. Kyle Haller and Jeff Haller were chasing it down. So a single for Assad. Wenzel pushes up to second. Joe Downing to the plate. Downing already has an RBI to his credit. Ansi will work from the stretch with two on and one out. He delivers, third base side, and it's going to get by the third baseman into left field. A run coming around to score. It's 5-2. And that is an error on LeBlanc, and a costly one as Wenzel comes around. Assad will push up to second. And Tyler Monahan will come up to the plate. A 5-2 game now. Monahan reached on an error in the first inning. Leg lift and the pitch. Down low. One and oh to Monahan. Upstairs. Good job by Reynolds gloving that one. That got by. Both runners would have easily pushed up. Looked like he was aiming for the high rising fastball there, and it rose a little too far. Hit in the air. This is crushed towards left field, towards the fence, and that is gone. A three-run homer, and this game is tied at five. Tyler Monahan powering that one out of the ballpark. Well, Tyler Monahan in that cleanup spot for a reason. The catcher certainly has some major power, and he showed it off there. That was only his first home run of the season. But also has a .346 batting average, very good hitter. And now Jeff Costello steps in, and that one's fouled away, 0-1. So a brand new ball game here in the third, all tied up at five. Well, with two offenses like this, you have to expect some run scoring. Leg lift and the pitch. There's ball one. Wind up and the pitch. There's a strike. He delivers, fouled away. And look out, cameraman over there on the third base side. One and two on Costello. Otsi gets the sign he likes and is set to deliver. There's a ball inside, two and two. Wind up and the pitch. And this is slugged in towards the second baseman, and a dive, did not make the catch, throws it over to first, and Costello is going to be safe. I thought Halloran was able to glove that, but it must have just fell out of his glove at the last possible second. So credit Costello with the single, and that'll bring up Sean Patinci, the right fielder. Certainly not an error on that one. That's the only play that Halloran had on that ball, really. Costello showing some speed going up the first baseline. Nancy from the stretch, runner leading off the bag at first. That's fouled away past the backstop, 0-1. Line up and the pitch. Breaking pitch down low, 1-1. Runner thought about taking off from first, but stays put. Line up and the pitch. Up high, checking at first. Good throw down the line, runner back safe. 2-1 on Patinci, who struck out his last time up in the second inning. Medway has plated four runs in this top of the third, and it's a 5-5 ball game. That pitch just outside. 3-1. A little bit of wind here for today's game. There's a swinging strike that'll fill up the count. The wind appears to be blowing out, so maybe that's helping the hitters as well. Some of these balls hit in the air, you are seeing them float a little bit more towards the outfield. Leg lift and the pitch, swinging strike, checking at first, and he almost picked him off. But the runner is back safe, but there is two outs in the inning as Patingi goes down. And that'll bring up Brian Colcassi. See from the stretch. Runner leading off of first. Ball one. 1-0. Nancy deals. Runner taking off from first, throw to second, is going to be in time. A great throw by Alex Reynolds. Jeff Costello caught stealing, and that is the third out of the inning, but not before the Medway Mustangs tie things up. They plate four runs in the top of the third. It's 5-5 as we head to the bottom of the third inning. Bottom of the third inning, Medway and Hopkinton all knotted up at five runs apiece. Two up for the Hillers, the 6, 7, and 8 hitters, Sam Lehman, Jeff Haller, and Connor Hebert. To face Nick Assad out there for his third inning of work. As Lehman steps in. Leg lift and the pitch. That's fouled away off the catcher. 0-1. Assad set to deal. Fouled away, 0-2. Wind up and the pitch, down low, 1-2. Lehman struck out his last time up in the first. 308 overall coming into this game for the senior. He's had a nice season at the plate. This is on the ground, up the middle, great dive by the second baseman. Throw to first is high, but did the first baseman lay the tag? No. So Lehman will be safe on the high throw. You could argue if that's an error or not. But I'll rule it a single. Jeff Haller will come up to the plate. So lead runner on, or lead hitter on for the bottom of the third for the Hillers. As Hopkinton trying to get back on top after Medway tied things up in the top of the third. They plated four runs. Leg lift and the pitch. Inside. 1-0. Assad from the stretch. Checking at first, runner just back safe. Good pickoff move from Assad. He deals. And this will take a hop on the infield, grass glove by the pitcher. Throw to second for one, throw to first, and they get the double play. And that was a 1-4-3 double play. And there is two outs in the inning. Connor Hebert will come up to the plate. Well, Mustangs certainly known for being a very good defensive team as well. And they showed a little bit of that there. Wind up and the pitch. Upstairs. One more. Saad delivers. That one just high. 2-0. Saad deals. Fouled away. 2-1. Saad delivers. There's strike two. 2-2. Wide up and the pitch. Strike three. And that will do it for the third inning. The ball game tied at 5 as we head to the top of the fourth. HCAMP Sports is supported by our viewers and by Hopkinton Drug, located in this historic New England town since 1954. They're a multifaceted store dedicated to providing clients with an array of healthcare options. Hopkinton Drug, located at 52 Main Street. Top of the fourth, first hitter at bat, and he will hit this in the air to right field, and that is going to fall into the glove of Connor Hebert for the first out of the inning. So now TJ Nelson will come up to the plate. Nelson grounded out his last time up in the second inning. Wind up in the pitch. There's strike one. 0-1. Onsi gets the sign he likes and deals. And this is lined past the reach of Vaccari into center field. It's a single. Jake Broder will come up to the plate. Broder struck out his last time up in the third. Bunt pulled back. Was a ball. Did not see the strike sign there by the umpire. Runner leading off of first. Onsi set to deal. Upstairs. 2-0 on Broder. Onsi delivers. Bunt pulled back. 3-0. Otzi deals. That bunt pulled back, and it's a four-pitch walk to Broder. Nelson advances to second. Jeff Wenzel to the plate. Two on, one out for the Mustangs. As Wenzel has a quick word with head coach Mike Coppinger before stepping in. Wenzel has walked twice in this game and scored two runs. Both runners leading as Onsi set to deliver. Bunt pulled back, strike one. Onsi takes a look at second and now deals. Breaking pitch, grabs the inner corner, 0-2. Wide up and the pitch. On the ground, right side. Glove by the second baseman, and he has no throw. Everybody's safe. Could not get the ball out of his glove. Nelson up to third, Broder up to second, a single for Wenzel. Nick Assad to the plate, bases loaded, one out. Take any base you want, Nick, bring him home. Pitcher versus pitcher here. Saad, 1-for-2 today, scored a run and hit a single in the third. There's strike one. Wind up and the pitch. That's fouled away. 0-2. Otsi deals. On the ground, first base side, that'll get into right field. One run already in a score, second run being waved around, and it is 7-5 Mustangs. A two RBI single for Nick Assad. TJ Nelson in, Jake Roeder in, Jeff Wenzel up to third. Joe Downing steps in, the left fielder. Still only one out in the inning with runners on the corners. Fouled away, third base side. 0-1. The Hillers look like we may be getting ready for some warm-up action. Otsi deals, just inside. 1-1. Wind up and the pitch. Inside, 2-1. Otsi delivers, third base side, and that's going to get by the reach of LeBlanc. One run in the score for the Mustangs. An RBI single for Downing. Wenzel comes around, an 8-5 lead for Medway. Nick Assad pushed up to second. And now the dangerous Tyler Monahan at the plate. He hit a three-run homer in the third. And that tied up the game at that point at 5. Otsi deals down low. Good block by Reynolds. Looks like Drew Simi getting loose for the Hillers. That pitch up high. Zonzi continues to struggle a little bit here. 2-0. Leg lift and the pitch. Check swing, couldn't hold. 2-1. 2-1, one out. Three runs already in the inning for the Mustangs. An 8-5 lead for Medway. Leg lift and the pitch is just inside. 3-1. Here we go, here we go. Otsi deals. Strike two, full count. Time called.
Hey, win this. Come on, Tyler. Come on, Tyler.
It's all yours, Ty.
Hey, Ty, hey, threes.
Otsi from the stretch. Leg lift and the pitch inside. Monahan draws the walk. Bases loaded for the Mustangs. And Head coach Jay Golden going to come out to the mound to have a word with Auncie, as well as the catcher Alex Reynolds. And there is a pair of pitchers getting loose for the Hillers. And coach here trying to give him a little more time. More than likely you'll see another pitcher next inning. Jeff Costello set to step in, 1-for-2 on the afternoon so far. Line up and the pitch on the ground up the middle. Auncie is able to make the play, throw to home, and they will get the fielder's choice. Good job by Auncie. So a 1-2 fielder's choice. As Assad picked off. Bases loaded, two outs. Sean Patingi at the plate. Turns him away, 1-0. Wind up and the pitch. That one's inside as well, 2-0. Line up and the pitch. Hit in the air, foul out of play. Two and one. Leg lift and the pitch. Just low, 3-1. Well, a walk here, run scores. Auncie deals. Fouled away into the umpire's chest guard. Full count. Seen a lot of that tonight. Well, balls into the catcher and into the umpire. Well, those chest protectors certainly doing their job today, that's for sure. Auncie gets the sign he likes and is set to deal. Runner taking off from third, and that's fouled away as the runner took off early. Perhaps trying the suicide squeeze type of situation there. Almost hit the runner with the foul ball. Full count, two outs, bases loaded. Wind up and the pitch. There's strike three, and that will retire the inning, but not before the Medway Mustangs plate three more runs. It is 8-5 as we head to the bottom of the fourth. The Hillers with some work to do as we enter the bottom of the fourth inning. An 8-5 lead for the Medway Mustangs after they plate three more runs in the top half of the inning. As Ryan Wolf is set to step in to face Nick Assad, who, after struggling a bit in the first inning, has been very good the last couple innings. Wolf awaits the pitch. He's 0-1 so far today. There's strike one, 0-1. Wind up and the pitch, down low. Set to deliver, swinging strike, 1-2. Wolf playing in his 12th game today of the season and will
foul this one away. One and two.
Wind up and the pitch. That's fouled away. Assad set to deliver the 1-2 pitch. Upstairs. Even count at 2-2. Assad delivers, and this is lined into right field. That'll drop in for a base hit. Lead runner on for the Hillers. Kyle Halloran will now come to the plate. 1-for-1 with a walk and a run scored today. Also an RBI to his credit. Checking at first, runner back safe. Well, if you're the Hillers, play it smart here. Be conservative on the base paths. Get a strong top of your order coming up. Chance to get right back into this game. Checking at first, runner back safe. Leg lift and the pitch, down low. Kyle Halloran is at a .424 batting average coming into this game. Has played in all Hillers games this season. Has scored 12 runs. That pitch just high. That's 10 RBIs as well. And this is fouled away third base side. Excuse me, it's 5 RBIs for Halloran. One and one count. Wind up and the pitch. Down low, good block. Runner will stay put at first. Nice block behind the plate there by Monahan. Leg lift and the pitch. Upstairs, and that'll draw the walk. Wolf up to second, Halloran on first. Now head coach Mike Coppinger is going to take the ball from Nick Assad. He will come out of the game after pitching 3-plus innings. As Jack Vicari due up to the plate. We'll get you updated on who the new pitcher is next. You are watching Hopkinton Hillers Baseball on HCAM. New pitcher in the game for the Medway Mustangs, Sean Patingi, the new pitcher, the junior. And he has plenty of experience this season. He started 5 games, has 5 appearances. He's 4-0 in his 5 appearances with a .72 ERA. Has 3 complete games, and he is in to try to clinch the TVL title for the Medway Mustangs. He replaces Nick Assad. Nick Assad still in the game. He moved over to right field. Patingi set to deliver. There's a strike to Vicari, 1-1. Two on for the Hillers, no outs in the inning. From the stretch, down low, two and one. Tenji deals. There's strike two. Two and two. Fouled away. Count remains two and two. Line up and the pitch upstairs. They'll fill it up. And this is going to take a couple hops on the infield grass. Throw to second, and everybody is going to be safe. Great job by Halloran rushing over to second base and a tremendous slide to beat out the throw. And you can credit Vicari with the single. So now the base is loaded, no outs. Alex Reynolds to the plate. Big opportunity here for Alex Reynolds. A pitch up high, 1-0. Wind up and the pitch. And this is hit into right field, and that is going to drop into fair territory. One run in, another run coming around, and the Hillers add two. It's 8-7. Ryan Wolf comes around as well as Kyle Halloran on a two RBI single from Alex Reynolds. Jack Vicari pushes up to third, and both of those runs will be credited to Nick Assad. We'll have a pinch runner for the Hillers as well. Stepping into the plate is Drew Simme. He'll take ball one, 1-0. Pinch runner over at first is the junior, Brett McIntyre. Pinch running for Alex Reynolds. Swinging strike. Well, when you saw the pitching matchup to this game and how well both teams have been playing as of late, this had absolute battle written all over it. As this is fair territory, third base side, throw to second in time. And that is going to be one out, runners on the corners. So Simme reaches on the fielder's choice. So 5-4, fielder's choice. Vicari remains at third. Reynolds picked off, Simme at first. LeBlanc to the plate. That pitch in there for a strike. Runners on the corners, one out. Two in for the Hillers, an 8-7 ball game. Checking at first, runner slides back safe. Wind up and the pitch, and this is hit in the air to center field, and a great catch, but tagging up and coming around is Vicari, and it is a tie game. Great catch in center field by Wenzel, but a nice tag up by Vicari, and the Hillers have tied up the ball game. Credit LeBlanc with the RBI. Drew Simme stayed at first. Sam Lehman to the plate. There's a strike. Checking at first, runner just back. Kenji from the stretch. Hit in the air, out of play, foul. Wide up and the pitch up high. One and one. Two outs, one on for the Hillers. Three runs in this inning as that one's fouled away. An 8-8 ball game. What a game this has been so far. Tenji awaits the sign and deals. Up high. That was just high. Wide up and the pitch. Third base side and foul. Tenji set to deal. Down low. Good block by Monahan. Runner back to first. Full count. Lehman 1-for-2 so far on the afternoon. And we'll check this one into the air. Foul out of play. And that ball will take a hop on the track over to the lacrosse game going on behind us. Checking at first, runner back safe. Well, so far this game has had just about everything you could ask for. Wind up and the pitch. And this is crushed in the air to center field, towards the fence. And that is going to be caught for the third and final out of the inning. And that was very close to home run territory. But Jeff Wenzel using his speed to range back and make the catch. But the Hopkinton Hillers have tied up the ball game once again as they play three runs in the bottom of the fourth. It is 8-8 as we head to the top of the fifth. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Angels Garden Center, located at 65 School Street. Growing in Hopkinton since 1957. You can find them online at angelsgardencenter.com. Top half of the fifth inning as the Hopkinton Hillers defense back on the field. Tom Auntie is out there for another inning of work, and we have ourselves a tie ball game, 8-8, as the first pitch of the top of the fifth is fouled away, and that is to the lacrosse game behind us. And the leadoff hitter this inning is Brian Colcassi, the first baseman. Medway batted around last inning as that one's fouled away. And that is going to make it 0-2. Leg lift and the pitch. Fouled away towards the Hillers dugout area. Ball just being hit all over the field today in fair and foul territory. Auntie deals, and that's fouled away. Count remains 0-2. A good battle going on here between the first baseman Colcassi and Tom Auntie. And you got to imagine the leash with Auntie is short. 1-2. Wind up and the pitch. And that is hit up above Auntie. Took a hop on the infield. Grass throw to first is in time. Good throw by Vakari.
All right, TJ, your turn.
One away, TJ Nelson to the plate. Hillers, they have a busy week this week. Three more games after today. All on the road. They have their tournament, Metro West tournament, this weekend. They'll be battling Franklin in the first round of that. As that pitch inside. And then, of course, it's going to depend who wins and loses in the first round to see who they'll be playing after that on this Saturday. That pitch upstairs. Two and O to Nelson. He's 1-for-2 today. Scored a run in the fourth. That pitch just outside. Wind up and the pitch. There's ball four. Jake Broder will come up, the second baseman. And now head coach Jay Golden going to come out, and I think we might have a pitching change. Let's see. Right now just talking to him. See if he takes the ball, and now we're going to get warm-up action once again for the Hillers. Drew Simmy's going to get loose. So they're going to give Simmy some time to get warm, leave Auntie in. But if anything happens from here on out, I think Auntie's likely going to be pulled from the game. As Broder will step in and is set for the pitch. Runner leading off of first. Upstairs.
Good eye, Broder, good eye. Come on, bring TJ around, Broder.
Runner leading off of first. Wide up and the pitch. Just inside. Two and O. The 2-0 pitch. There's a strike, 2-1. Auntie deals, pulled back. 3-1. Wind up in the pitch. The bunt is down and pulled back. Ball four. Second walk for Auntie, and that's going to do it. Have to pull him now. Two on, one out. Jeff Wenzel due up for the Hillers. And we're going to have a pitching change here in Hopkinton. Drew Simmy will come in for the Hillers to try to close out this inning and keep the ball game tied. We'll take a quick timeout. It's Medway 8, Hopkinton 8. You're watching Hillers Baseball on HCAM. The new pitcher for the Hopkinton Hillers is Drew Simmy. He was the designated hitter to start today's game. Tom Auntie still responsible for the runners on first and second as he walked a pair. There is one out in the inning. This is Drew Simmy's ninth appearance on the mound for the Hillers. He's started two games so far this season as a 2.71 ERA. Both runners leading as Simmy delivers. And there is a strike to Jeff Wenzel, the leadoff hitter for the Medway Mustangs. And Wenzel having himself a day, 3 runs scored, 1-for-1 at the plate, pair of walks. Simmy with the leg lift and the pitch, and that pitch just high, 1-1. Simmy has 3 saves to his credit. Wind up and the pitch. There's a strike. 1-2. Come on, chase that. runners leading. Simi set to deliver. On the ground, up the middle, glove by Simi. Deciding where to go with it, we'll just go to first and get the second out of the inning. So a 1-3 ground out for Wenzel. Pushing up to third is Nelson. Broder up to second. Nick Assad to the plate. Assad is 2-for-2 at the plate. Had a sacrifice in the first. Singled and scored a run in the third. 2 RBI single in the fourth. Simi deals. And this is going to take a couple hops on the infield. Grass glove by the third baseman. Throw to first is not in time. And two runs are going to score for the Mustangs. TJ Nelson came around from third, and Broder all the way from second comes around. And it is 10-8 on the 2 RBI single from Nick Assad. Well, Assad certainly helping his own cause in this game. Wow. Responsible for 4 RBIs for the Mustangs and also a run. 10-8 Medway as Joe Downing steps in. Turns away the hitter, 1-0. Simi set the deal. That throw would have been very tough to get across by LeBlanc, especially that where the ball ended up. 1-1. That is just what the Mustangs wanted right there. Simi deals, runner taking off from first. Reynolds will bobble it, and the runner will easily steal second as Assad is now in scoring position. Two-one count on Downing. Runner leading off of second, Simi. We'll take a look over and deal. And this is hit in the air, a high fly ball towards left field, ranging under it and making the catch is Sam Lehman for the third and final out of the inning, but not before the Medway Mustangs plate two more runs courtesy of a Nick Assad 2 RBI single. It is 10-8 Medway as we head to the bottom of the fifth. Bottom of the fifth inning as the Hillers will come back up to the plate, trailing now 10-8. Due up is the 7, 8, and 9 hitters, Jeff Haller, Connor Hebert, and Ryan Wolf, to face Sean Patingi in his second inning of work in this game. Hillers plated three more runs on the bottom of the fourth. At that point, the game was tied at 8 apiece. And then two more by the Mustangs in the fifth. That one fouled away, 0-1. Patingi set to deal. Fouled off the catcher, 0-2. And hitter's contact in this game is very high. Lineup and the pitch upstairs. You are not getting a whole lot of swinging and missing at all. 1-2. Leg lift and the pitch. Just low. 2-2. Haller awaits the pitch, and he will get a piece of this one, grounded over to the shortstop, throw to first in time. 6-3 goes Haller, one away. Connor Hebert to the plate. Hebert 1-for-2 in this game. Cotingi deals. There's a strike, 0-1. Wind up and the pitch. In there for strike two, 0-2. Patenji deals just inside. 1-2. Wind up and the pitch. That one outside. 2-2. Leg lift and the pitch. And this is up the middle, gloved at short. Throw to first, a little high, and it'll pull the first baseman off the bag. He's safe. Hebert reaches on the errant throw. Ryan Wolf to the plate, one on, one out. The tying run coming to the plate. Wolf singled and scored a run in the fourth. Takes a strike here. From the stretch, checking at first, runner slides back safe. Wind up and the pitch, just low. One and one. Checking at first. Runner slides back. Set the deal, and this is hit in the air. This is going to drop into shallow center field and then get by the second baseman. It's going to end up being a single for Wolf. Hebert up to second. Two on, one out. Top of the order coming up. Kyle Halloran will step in. At this point, predicting what is going to happen in this game is nearly impossible. Halloran at the plate having a nice day, has walked twice, singled, scored two runs, and driven in a run. He'll take strike one there. Wind up and the pitch. On the ground, up the middle, will take a hop off the mound, gloved by the second baseman, throw to first, is going to be in time. That'll be the second out of the inning, so a 4-3 ground out by Halloran. Hebert did push up to third, Wolf up to second. Jack Vaccari to the plate. Vaccari having himself a nice day, 2-for-3 at the plate, two singles. And two runs scored, as well as a stolen base to his credit. And we'll foul that one away, 0-1. Line up and the pitch, outside. 1-1. Dingy set the deal, and that is going to be called a ball, 2-1. Dingy deals just outside, 3-1. Line up and the pitch, upstairs, Vaccari draws the walk. Bases loaded, two outs. Alex Reynolds, the catcher, coming up to the plate. And now head coach Mike Coppinger, as well as Tyler Monahan, going to head over to the mound and have a chat with Patenji. Alex Reynolds having a nice day. 2-for-3 at the plate, a pair of singles. Has four RBIs, two RBI single in the first, two RBI single in the fourth. Also scored a run in the first. And a big opportunity here to either give the Hillers the lead or tie things up. And Reynolds has just had an outstanding season at the plate. As the junior steps in, 440 batting average coming into this game, takes strike one. Played in all 16 Hillers games. 11 runs scored, 15 batted in. Breaking pitch, called a ball, 1-1. Tingy deals, upstairs, 2-1. If Reynolds reaches, Drew Simi due up on deck. And this is hit into right field, and that'll drop down for a base hit. One run in, another run being waved around, and that is going to be a tie game. And now Vaccari coming around, and he'll score as well. It's 11-10 Hillers. But then the hitter, Alex Reynolds, thrown out as he goes to third. But no worries, as Hebert, Wolf, and Vaccari all come around to score, and the Hillers once again take the lead on the 3 RBI double by Alex Reynolds. We will head to the top of the sixth. It's 11-10 Hopkinton. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Weston Nurseries, located at 93 East Main Street. You could visit their garden centers in Hopkinton or Chelmsford and find them online at westonnurseries.com. Well, this has been one exciting game, to say the least, as the Hillers have regained the lead 11-10 as we head to the top of the sixth. Tyler Monahan, the cleanup hitter, at the plate. He'll take strike one. Drew Simi on the mound for his second inning of work. This game has just gone back and forth, nonstop. Line up and the pitch. There's a strike. 0-2. Well, Medway scored a run in the top of the first. The Hillers answered with 5 in the bottom of the inning. Get you updated on the rest in a minute. That one inside. Second inning, no one scored. Top of the third, Medway scores 4 more, ties it up at 5. And then the top of the fourth, Medway adds 3 more and makes it an 8-5 Mustangs lead. And then the Hillers tied up at 8 in the bottom of the fourth. Wind up and the pitch from Simi. Down low, gets by Reynolds, 2-2. And then in the top of the fifth, Medway takes a 10-8 lead. And then in the bottom of the fifth, the Hillers add 3 runs and now lead 11-10. So there's your summary in a nutshell. As Simi set for the 2-2 pitch. Lined up and the pitch, and that's fouled away. And it's been a kind of a hitter's fest here in this game today. Simi hoping to calm things down as he is set to deliver upstairs. Full count on Monahan. Tyler Monahan hit a 3-run homer in the third inning, a ball which he absolutely crushed past the left field fence. Simi deals upstairs and he draws the walk. So the tying run is on for Medway. Jeff Costello, the third baseman, will come up to the plate. And we're gonna have a pinch runner for the Mustangs. So Monahan gets the job done, and Justin Belforti is going to be the pinch runner, junior. Simi set to deal. There's a swinging strike. Both of these teams, though, playing a tremendous game and a lot on the line here. Medway, if they win today, they clinch the TVL title. If the Hillers win, they clinch a playoff spot. And both teams certainly battling like there is something on the line today. As this is hit in the air, it is in foul territory. Is it in his reach? And it is. Little scoop catch there by LeBlanc for the out. Nice job by LeBlanc, one away. Sean Patingi to the plate. So one away, one on. Runner on first. Mustangs have not had a scoreless inning offensively since the second. Bunt pulled back. Runner taking off from first. Throw over is going to be in time. A beauty of a throw by Alex Reynolds. And the pinch runner, Justin Belfort, he caught stealing. Two away. Patingi steps back in. Wind up and the pitch. Upstairs. Simi set to deliver. On the ground, up the middle, glove by Vaccari. Throw to first is going to be in time. A 6-3 ground out for Patingi. And for the first time since the second inning, Medway goes scoreless offensively. We will head to the bottom of the sixth. The Hillers leading Medway 11-10. Bottom of the sixth inning, the Hillers leading Medway 11-10. And for those of you just joining us, you have missed out on an absolutely wild game. As it has just gone back and forth, Drew Simi steps in. Simi started the game as the DH, and now has pitched the last couple innings, takes ball one there. Sean Patingi still in there for Medway. He took over for Nick Assad, the starter. There's a swinging strike, 1-1. Patingi took over in the fourth inning. He was originally the right fielder. And this is hit in the air to center field. And ranging under it to make the catch is Jeff Wenzel, one away. And now Jake LeBlanc will come up to the plate. Blank steps in, takes a ball. And despite 21 runs being scored, this game has pretty much moved at the usual speed. So there's a strike, about 2 hours old, just over 2 hours old. Wind up and the pitch. And this is hit in the air towards center field. Pushing back to make the catch is Wenzel. And wind certainly has been a factor in this game, and it is working to the advantage of the hitters in this one, as Sam Lehman will come up to the plate. Wind up and the pitch. There's a strike. Patingi is 1-for-3 today, singled in the third. And there's another strike. 0-2. Wind up and the pitch. And this is hit in the air to center field, and this one will be handled as well by Jeff Wenzel. So three pop-outs to center field. And the Medway Mustangs will come up down to their last three outs on the top of the seventh, with the Hillers leading the game 11-10. Welcome back to Hopkinton High School. We are set for the top half of the seventh. The Mustangs down to their final three outs, trailing 11-10 to the Hillers. And what is been an absolutely wild one here on senior night in Hopkinton. Brian Kolkassi steps in, Drew Simi set to deliver. And this is on the ground up the middle off of Simi, picks it up, throws it a first, one away. A 1-3 ground out. Nice job by Simi staying with it. And Simi might be hurt on this one. The umpire going to come out and check up on him. He took that one right off the shin. And he might need a minute to shake that off. Maybe come out of the game. I don't know. Hopefully he could just shake it off. The trainer's going to come out and check on him as well. So while that happens, we'll take a pause here on the HCAM broadcast with the Hillers leading Medway 11-10. Continuing on in the top of the seventh, Drew Simi remains in the game after taking a ball off the leg, hit up the middle by Colcassie, which Simi, despite getting hit off the leg with it, was still able to pick it up and throw to first for the out. One out in the inning. Bases empty for Medway. TJ Nelson steps into the batter's box, and Simi is set to deal. Upstairs, 1-0. Hillers, two outs away from clinching a spot in the postseason. Is that pitch up high, 2-0. But in this game against this Medway batting order, those two outs are not easy outs. Simi deals inside. Three and oh on Nelson. The bunt pulled back, draws the walk, tying run on base. Jake Broder coming to the plate. 0 for 1, has walked twice and scored two runs. Leadoff hitter due up on deck for Medway. Jeff Wenzel. Broder steps back into the box and Simi set to deal from the stretch. 1-0. There's a strike, 0-1. Leg lift and the pitch. There's strike two. 0-2. Simi deals. Hit in the air, high fly ball to right field, and that is going to be dropped by the right fielder, and the runner is going to advance to second. It'll be first and second with one out for the Mustangs. And that is a costly error. It could be very costly. Was Connor Hebert out there. And Hebert just could not get a good grip on it. So two on, one out. Jeff Wenzel at the plate. Take strike one. Some serious gas there by Simi. Line up and the pitch. Swinging strike, 0-2. Simi going with the gas now. Simi deals. Strike three, two away. Nick Assad will step in. And Assad has had a great day at the plate. 3 for 3 with a sacrifice. 4 RBIs and a run scored. Mustangs down to their final out. Drew Simi versus Nick Assad. That one down low. Assad was the starting pitcher, then moved over to right field. C Simi deals. Fouled away, 1-1. Leg lift and the pitch. Inside, 2-1. Line up and the pitch. Down low, 3-1. Simi deals, and that's fouled away, full count. Every single out in this game just about has been an absolute battle. Hopkinton leading Medway 11-10, top of the seventh. Medway down to their final out. Runners on first and second, a full count on Nick Assad. The leg lift and the pitch, fouled away. Count remains full. If Nick Assad reaches, Joe Downing, the left fielder, due up on deck. Simi deals, hit in the air, high fly ball, foul territory, and count will remain full.
All right, Nicky. All right, Nick. All right, still alive. Catches.
Simi set to deliver. On the ground, up the middle. Gloved and bobbled by the shortstop. The throw home is going to get away, and the ball game's tied. A bobble by Vaccari, an errant throw home, and it's 11-11. TJ Nelson comes around. And that'll bring up Joe Downing. Mustangs still with a chance to take the lead. Well, this game not over yet. Simi deals. There's a strike. So two errors by the Hillers in this inning has expanded the ball game for at least another half inning. Simi delivers. Check swing couldn't hold 0-2. Line up and the pitch. Strike three, the ball briefly got away. Throw to first, no problem. That's the third out of the top of the seventh. But the Medway Mustangs plate a run. It's 11-11 as we head to the bottom of the seventh. Bottom of the seventh inning. This game all knotted up between Medway and Hopkinton at 11 apiece. The Mustangs added a run in the top half of the inning to tie up the game. And the Hillers, they do have a chance to walk off here if they can get the hitting going. Due up is the 7, 8, and 9 hitters. Jeff Haller will start things off. And Patingi delivers a strike. And two errors expanded this game, two Hiller's errors. There's strike two. Set to deliver. Swinging strike, three-pitch strikeout to Holler. One away. Connor Hebert now coming up to the plate. We're gonna have a pinch hitter. Pinch hitter for the Hillers, the windup and the pitch. And this is hit into left field, and that is going to be caught as Nate Wilson, the senior, will fly out. Good catch there by Joe Downing. Two-way. And now Ryan Wolf to the plate, the first baseman. Nate Wilson likely in for the rest of the game for Connor Hebert. As there's a strike, 0-1. Hebert had a ugly error in the top of the seventh. There's strike two. Patinji, he might just be finding his stride right here. And sure, the momentum certainly helping him along as that pitch down low, 1-2. Wolf's had a good game. He's 2-for-3 at the plate. Pair of singles and also scored two runs. Line up and the pitch. Up the middle, glove by Patinji. He'll take this himself for the third and final out of the seventh inning, a one unassisted ground out. We will head to the top of the eighth. The ball game between Medway and Hopkinton tied at 11. Top of the eighth inning, ball game tied at 11 apiece. Drew Simme still in the game. Due up for the Mustangs, the 4, 5, and 6 hitters as Tyler Monahan will step in. Medway tied it up in the top of the seventh after a couple Hiller's errors, a drop in right field, and an errant throw home from Vicari, allowed the run to score as this one's crushed into left field, past the glove of LeBlanc, and that'll drop down for a leadoff single. Monahan aboard, Jeff Costello to the plate. Costello is 1-for-4. Wind up and the pitch. The bunt is fouled away, 0-1. This game has been back and forth the entire way. Medway trying to clinch the TVL title as that one's bunted foul. And the Hillers trying to clinch a playoff spot. Both teams just need to win today. 0-2. Simme delivers upstairs. One and two. Lined up and the pitch. Fouled away. Leg lift and the pitch, upstairs. 2-2.
Come on, let's go once. Come on, once, hang in there, battle it.
Leg lift and the pitch, fouled away.
Still hanging in, okay. Way to go, way to right on it.
Simi set to deal. Swinging strike. There's out number one. That'll bring up Sean Patingi. Simi came in relief of Tom Onsi in the fifth inning. That was after Onsi walked two batters with one out. There's a strike. Both of those runners would end up scoring on a two RBI single by Nick Assad in the fifth. At that point, it gave the Mustangs a 10-8 lead. Then the Hillers took the lead on the bottom of the inning as that pitch outside, 1-1, led 11-10 until the top of the seventh, which the Mustangs took advantage of a couple errors. TJ Nelson ended up coming around to score, tying the game up at 11. Leg lift and the pitch, just outside. 2-1. Simi deals. On the ground, left side, that'll get through the gap and be a base hit. Runners on first and second with one out. Monahan pushes up to second. Patingi aboard. Brian Kolkassi due up to the plate.
Come on, 1-0. Make sure he knows where he's going on the ball back. All yours. It's in your court. You've been here before. Let's do it. Come on, 1-0.
Simi deals. Foul away, 0-1. TJ Nelson due up next. Kolkassi 0 for 4 today. Simi has done pretty well though in this relief effort. He's done very well. Throwing a lot of pitches here in a battle with a very tough lineup as their strike two. 0-2, one out, two on. Game tied at 11, we're in the top of the eighth. And time called by the hitter. Simi from the stretch. Leg lift and the pitch. Swinging strike, and he got him. Second strikeout of the inning. Two outs, two on, TJ Nelson to the plate. There has been no warm-up action for the Hillers, so Simi is more than likely the pitcher from here on out, unless, of course, we have many more extra innings. Line up and the pitch. And this is hit up the left side. That'll get into left field. Tyler Monahan, the lead runner, being waved around third. He'll come in and score. And the Medway Mustangs take the 12-11 lead. Tyler Monahan coming around to score. And wow, unbelievable. An RBI double for TJ Nelson. As Monahan comes around to score, Patingi pushes up to third. And the Mustangs excited to say the least about that. As Broder steps in. Simi set to deal. There's a strike. 0-1. Leg lift and the pitch. Up high. One and one. A 12-11 Medway lead. Simi deals. Ball two. Chance to add more here for the Mustangs. Two runners in scoring position. Two outs. The leg lift and the pitch. On the ground, left side, glove by LeBlanc. Throw to first, in time, no problem. That'll be the third out of the inning, but not before an RBI base hit by TJ Nelson allows Tyler Monahan to score. It is 12-11 Medway as we head to the bottom of the eighth. Bottom of the eighth inning, the Hillers top of the order coming up. Still in the game on the mound, Sean Patingi. That one outside. Kyle Halloran at the plate. One for two with a pair of walks and a pair of runs. There's a strike, one and one. The Mustangs added a run in the top half of the eighth to take the lead. An RBI base hit by Nelson. Left side, glove by the third baseman. Throw to first. High, pulls the first baseman off. Was he able to lay the tag? And they're going to call him out. Good job by Kyle Cassie at first base. That throw really pulled him off, but he stretched that arm out and got the tag on Halloran. One away. Jack Vaccari to the plate. This is the most potent part of the Hillers lineup at the plate this inning. Exactly who you would want at the plate. 1-0. Wind up and the pitch. That's hit foul. 1-1. Set to deliver. Fouled away. 1-2. Alex Reynolds due up on deck. Patingi delivers upstairs. Right now, Patingi on the hook for the win, and Simi on the hook for the loss. Swinging strike. Vaccari goes down swinging. Two away. Reynolds to the plate. Alex Reynolds has had a great game. 3-for-4.
Sean, you cut him right down there. Let's go.
Also has 5 RBIs.
Come on, Sean, let's finish it.
Actually make that 6 RBIs. That pitch down low, 1-0. Two outs for the Hillers. Base paths clear. Alex Reynolds trying to come through here. Take strike one, 1-1. No matter how this game ends, what a fight by both these teams. This is a classic. That pitch down low. Patingi set to deal. Upstairs, 3-1. Wind up and the pitch. And this is hit in the air, foul territory and out of play on the left side. And that was caught. He ran over and caught that, but that might have been out of play. That's out of play. He actually chased that one down. That is out of play. Good effort though. So Reynolds will come back up to the plate with a full count.
All right, let's go, John. Go tight. Come on, Midway.
Reynolds awaits the pitch. Up high, and he gets the walk. Tying run aboard. Drew Simme now stepping in. Simme is 0 for 3 with a walk and a run scored in the first. Dingy deals. Up high. 1-0. Wind up and the pitch. And this is going to take a couple hops on the infield grass, picked up by the third baseman. Throw to first. In time. And the Medway Mustangs are the TVL champions as they come away with the 12-11 victory over the Hopkinton Hillers. And what was an absolutely amazing ball game. What a battle between these two teams. And congratulations to Medway on coming away with a tremendous win. The Mustangs ended up scoring their 12 runs on 11 hits, committed one error. Well, the Hopkinton Hillers plated 11 runs on 12 hits and committed four errors. Just a tremendous game that went back and forth the whole way through. The Medway Mustangs plated the first run of the game in the top half of the first. An RBI sacrifice from Joe Downing scored Jeff Wenzel, but then the Hillers came up in the bottom of the first and they plated five runs. A two RBI single by Alex Reynolds plated Halloran and Vicari. And that was with no outs. And then Simme would walk, LeBlanc singled, Lehman struck out, an RBI single by Haller, an RBI single by Hebert. At that point, it made it 5-1. The Mustangs struck back on the top of the third. They plated four runs in the top of the third. And Tyler Monahan had a three-run home run in that inning. And that would once again tie up the game at 5. And that was after Jeff Wenzel scored on Joe Downing, reaching on an error. So then heading into the fourth, both teams would end up putting up three runs in the inning, a two RBI single by Nick Assad, an RBI single by Joe Downing for the Mustangs on the top of the inning. And then on the bottom of the inning, a two RBI single for Alex Reynolds and a sacrifice fly up by LeBlanc. So at that point, it would be 8-8. The Mustangs would add two more in the top half of the fifth. Two RBI single by Nick Assad scored TJ Nelson and Jake Broder. But then the Hillers struck right back in the bottom of the fifth as they scored three runs of their own. A three RBI double by Alex Reynolds scored Hebert, Wolf, and Vicari. So the Hillers were once again in control, up 11-10 until the top of the seventh, where the Mustangs would end up plating a run as TJ Nelson would score after a couple of errors. Nick Assad reached on an error, and at that point, that's where Nelson scored, and then the Mustangs get the job done in the top of the eighth. An RBI base hit by TJ Nelson scores Tyler Monahan, and that was your ball game. Certainly a game for the ages, an instant classic here at Hopkinton High School. The final score for the final time, the Medway Mustangs defeat the Hopkinton Hillers 12-11. The winning pitcher is Sean Patingi. The losing pitcher, Drew Simme, both came in relief, but an unbelievable ball game by both these teams. And once again, congratulations to the TVL champion, Medway Mustangs. For Bob Hamilton on camera, I'm Tom Nappy. We thank you for joining us and watching this Hiller Sports production here on HCAM. Enjoy the rest of your day, everybody.